guys, welcome or welcome back to my channel. My name is Mary Kate, this is House of Style, and today I'm going to be doing a belt collection video. And I'm so excited to do this because I love vintage belts, and I have a lot. Obviously you don't need to collect belts or have an excess amount of belts, but I just love using belts to kind of create more, I don't know, styled outfits. I personally love wearing a good belt with a good pair of high-waisted jeans. So today I'm going to be showing you my belt collection and also kind of talking to you guys about how I style them, things like that. This isn't really going to be like a, this is a belt and then show an outfit, because that would take literally 10 hours to do. So I'm just going to be talking about each belt, why I like it, why I chose it, where I got it from, and how I style it personally. So let's get into it. Alright guys, the first belt is super sentimental to me because one of my best friends got it for me, and she's awesome. Hi Courtney. But she got them for me, and this is a vintage Mimi DN belt, and it's really awesome. I actually had one before she gifted this one to me, but I really, really like it because I love the color, and these are removable belt buckles, so if it keeps coming off, like, no worries. But yeah, this one's really, really awesome. I just loved, if you guys can see, it's kind of like a snake print, and then it has these really awesome, they almost look like G's. I don't really know what they're supposed to be, but let's see what year this is from. This is from 1981. And if you guys don't know about Mimi DN, she is a really, really awesome belt designer. She was really big in the 70s and 80s, and her belts were featured in Vogue and really awesome places like that. So this is a really awesome belt. And yeah, I would just literally wear this with a pair of high-waisted jeans like I usually always do. But yeah, I really, really love this belt. I haven't gotten a chance to wear it yet because I'm still trying to figure out how I want to style it. And this is more of like a springtime belt. But I'm sure I can make it into a fall-time belt with two, with like a really, really cool turtleneck and some jeans or something. But I really love this. The next belt was also gifted to me by my friend Courtney. So again, thank you, Courtney. It's a really, really awesome belt from Amy Lynn. I'd never really heard of this before, but it's so cool. I love it. It's very Western, so this will be perfect for this fall. But I just love it. I think I would wear it with a dress, probably a turtleneck dress or something to kind of spice it up. But I just love this medallion detail. And then the back is just so beautiful. I love the embroidery of the belt, and the color and everything is just, it's so me in a belt. So I'm really excited to style this as well. Alright, moving on, we have this really amazing corset belt that I found at Goodwill, and this is from Hugo Boss, and these belts range from, I think, $300 to $600, so I was really oddly surprised that I found it at Goodwill. But it's just an amazing corset belt that I wear with a lot of dresses just to give my figure a little more shape. But it just has some red stitching detailing, and then it just has like a two belt kind of deal going on with gold accents, and I just think it's an awesome belt and I love wearing it. And by the way, these belts are in no particular order. I'm just kind of picking them up from the ground as I go. The next belt you guys would have seen in my fall 2018 trends video if you watched it, but it's this really awesome vintage Pelletier belt. Found this at Goodwill as well. It's just a really beautiful white. What kind of drew me to this was the starkness of the white with the gold. I just really liked it. It was very 80s to me. My sister hates this belt, but I think it's really cool. And I just love the gold with the rope. It's just amazing. I couldn't get enough of this belt. And I love wearing it in the wintertime because this is kind of like a wintry white color. So I just really love wearing it with black or, you know, really, you can wear it with anything. I think if you wear it with a color, it kind of looks too 80s. If you're into that, that's awesome, but I'm not, so I think I really just wear this with, like, black or white. Dresses, pants, navy blue is cool, too, for the spring, but yeah, I just really love this belt. Alright, the next belt was really awesome as well. It's by the brand Roberto Dalpra. If it's a little worn, so I can't really see what it's really by, but, or who it's really by, but it's so beautiful. I loved just how kind of funky it was. I loved how, you know, it just looks like a plain black belt, but then you have these really amazing diamonds all around, and I thought this was very Western, but so beautiful. And I love wearing this with like a bodysuit and like black bodysuit and some high-waisted jeans, and I throw this on. I love it. It's so chic, it's so beautiful, and it's very now because it's very Western. All right, the next belt was a really awesome find. This is a Elisabetta Franchi per Celine B, which means it's for the brand Celine B, so I guess they had a collaboration, or maybe she owns a brand or something, I don't know, but it's Italian, and it reminded me of Chanel. You know, you see those like staple Chanel belts that kind of look like this, so that's, you know, kind of why I picked it up. But this looks amazing with a shirt dress because it just is so simple. But it's just a patent leather like rope belt, and then it has accents of the rose gold, and then a cute little like medallion chain that just says the brand. And it's just, I love this. It's just adorable. It looks really, really awesome with, like, I have this maxi cardigan that I wear it with, and I wear it over it, so I kind of make it more like a dress, and it looks really cute. Or I wear it with shirt dresses, and I just really love this belt. And I got it at Goodwill as well. Okay, the next belt was a very recent find. I haven't had a chance to wear it yet because it's just so different, but I got this at Goodwill. And it's just a really cool, like, bullseye belt. It's a giant medallion, and then it looks like it has fish scales going all around. Not really sure. There's no brand on this or anything, but I thought it was really, really cool to wear with a dress or something to give it that kind of unique edge, or maybe another pair of high-waisted jeans. But yeah, I really, really liked how edgy this was and different, and just gives a little something-something to a rather boring outfit. Alright, the next one is a little weird, I'm not gonna lie, but I thought it would be cool in the wintertime with a pair of, like, I don't know, I was envisioning it with a sweater and some dark jeans or pants or something. I don't know, really. But I'm going to show it because it's kind of weird. I think someone made this themselves. But it's just this really interesting leather belt. And it has a bunch of stars and unicorns on it. I don't really know why I picked this up. I haven't had a chance to wear it yet. But I thought it was kind of wintery and fall and kind of cool. You don't really find belts like this on the market unless you go to a thrift store. So that's kind of why I got it. But it literally looks like someone just like carved out the stars and the unicorns, but I don't really care. I still think it's cool, and I definitely am gonna find a place to wear this. Alright, the next belt is one you would have seen if you watched my Stan Smith video, but it's this really, really pretty, like, I call it my WWE belt. It's just a gorgeous beaded belt with, I thought this was a butterfly, but it's obviously not. I don't know what it is exactly, but it's just gorgeous, and I love wearing this in the winter and fall time with, like, skirts and jeans and stuff, and I think it's really, really cool and funky, and not for the faint of heart, but, you know, I say experiment. This next belt you would have seen if you watched my latest video, and it's just this really cool Western looking black and silver belt. It's more of a gunmetal silver, but it just is a beautiful, has really cool detailing on the buckles, and that's kind of what drew me in, and I literally wear this belt to death. I wear it with my Calvins and a black tank and this belt and some heels, and that's like basically my uniform. That's what I wear all the time. Okay, this next belt my best friend also gave to me. This is just a really awesome vintage Delore medallion belt. It's just a really, really cool, like, double medallion, and then it has this really stretchy material, so I love this. It's definitely from, like, the 80s, I believe. I'd never really heard of Delore, but it's a removable belt buckle, so I can, like, find different belts to fit with it, or, like, you know, different belt material. But, yeah, with a pair of jeans and some, like, a black sweater or something. I have, like, a really cool philosophy black sweater that will look really awesome with this. So I'm excited to wear it in the wintertime. Okay, this next belt is from the brand Antoine Egner. I completely butchered that, and I'm so sorry. I don't know French, but I find his stuff in the thrift store all the time. But I really, really liked this belt. It was simple. It just has, like, the logo of his brand, which I'm sure you guys have seen before. And yeah, I just really liked it for some reason. I love wearing this with a pair of jeans and a tee. Not sure why, but it's really cool. And I don't know if this is vintage or not. It might not be, but it doesn't matter. But I found this at Goodwill as well. Okay, this next belt is one of my favorites. I found this at a vintage store in downtown Frederick, and it's gorgeous. It is an Escada vintage belt. It's just a purple suede with a gold buckle, obviously, and then this really amazing gold tassel. And I love this so much. This is one of my favorite belts that I've ever had. And Escada is a really, really good brand, so I was really happy to find this. I did pay a little bit of money for it. I think it was around $30, which is a lot, but I love belts and I'm a collector of them, so I figured it was worth the investment because the one thing about belts is they never go out of style. So yeah, I just love these so, so much. All right, this next belt I found off of Poshmark, and it came with a dress, but the dress is a little too big, so I'm gonna have to get it altered eventually. But I love this. It's just a Prada belt, and it's just baby blue, and you guys would have seen me wear this in my Stan Smith video as well. I wore this with kind of like a Carrie Bradshaw looking skirt with a black cami, not a cami, a black tank, and this, and I just love the combination with my Stan Smiths. But yeah, I just really love this belt. I think it's really pretty sophisticated and simple. And sometimes a simple belt with like a little bit of a logo is good. I'm not a huge fan of the Gucci belts because everyone kind of has them, and I think it's getting repetitive. But I really like how simple the Prada logo is. Like, I can wear it and not be like, oh my god, I look, you know, like I'm trying too hard, or I look like I'm, you know, trying to tell people that I have a lot of money or something. Yeah, I really like how simple the logo is, and I just like the baby blue. Alright, this next belt you would have seen in my last video as well. It's just this really cool coin medallion belt. Gave me Versace vibes, without it being Versace, but I just really like it, and you would have seen how I styled it in my last video. I think wearing it with like t-shirts and like a cool maxi skirt or something is really chic. Or even, I was looking at pictures from New York Fashion Week, and a lot of people wore like giant coin belts with t-shirts and maxi skirts, so that's kind of where I got the idea from. Even wearing this with like a really cool black dress or something to spice it up would be awesome. Or even like a high-waisted pair of jeans and like a pinafore top or something would be cool too. This next belt I literally wear to death. I got this at Goodwill and I am in love with it. It's this really beautiful just plain black leather belt, and then it has this amazing gold circle. I mean, you guys can see. The brand either says Cartier or Carter. I'm not going to hold my breath that it's Cartier because found it at Goodwill and I'm sure it's not. It wouldn't be kind of, it's not falling apart, but it's not in the best condition because I've literally worn it to death probably 100 times by now. But yeah, it's just so beautiful. I thought it was very high fashion, and I wore this all the time with like my Calvins and like a flowy top and this and some heels. And I think it looks very, very beautiful. Okay, this next belt is by the brand Remo Tolani, and I'm pretty sure this is a men's belt. But this is a calfskin leather, which was kind of sad to find at a thrift store, but it's just hanging there, so I figured I'd put it to good use. And I just really liked it because of the simplicity of the belt. It's a little like kind of snake skinny print, and then you have these really beautiful silver, what do you call these? I don't know, details to the belt, and then on the tip of the belt, it has just more silver here, and I thought it was very simple. It's a little big for me, but if I just, you know, have it like this, then it works. Instead of using, you know, like the holes that it has on it. But yeah, I just really liked this. I thought it was very simple, but chic. We're getting down to the last few belts here. This one is just a really cool vintage-y looking gold belt. It just has a bunch of chain link gold details to it. I don't know what else to say. And it just has this really cool like tassel-y thing. This kind of looks like a pear, but it's just really, really pretty tassel. And I love wearing like, this is like the other belt I showed you, but it's gold obviously. And I just really like wearing like belts like this with a shirt dress. I don't know why. I think it's cool and funky, and I also like wearing it with maxi dresses as well, but I really lucked out on finding this. I think I got it from Goodwill for like a dollar, which was a steal if you ask me, and it's just so gorgeous. Alright, I saved my favorite belts for last here. This is another Mimi DN belt, but this is from 1972, and I swear to god I looked down on this. It's so awesome. It's just this really, really cool lion, or that's not a lion, it's just this really cool tiger belt, and I wear this all the time with a pair of jeans and just a tee, and I think it adds like a Gucci vibe to it. But I literally love this belt to death. Again, I was really psyched that it was from the 70s because it's really, truly vintage. But it's beautiful and I love it. And I found this on my birthday actually. So this was a really awesome find last year. But I literally love this belt and I wish I would wear it more. I get kind of habitual with belts and I kind of wear the same like three. But I still love experimenting with different kinds of belts and collecting them. So this is just a really, really good find, and I was really pumped to wear it. Right, this next belt you would have seen me thrift in my latest haul, but it's just this gorgeous, like, beaded gold belt, and then it has a really, really pretty oval medallion in the front. And I don't even know where this is from, but I just love this so much. I love wearing it with my high-waisted Levi's shorts and a graphic tee. I don't know why, but I just love this belt, and I think I got it for around like $2, so another steal, but yeah, it's amazing. All right, we have our last two belts here. This is a really awesome find from Goodwill. This is a Ralph Lauren belt. What really drew me to this was the circle. It just says Ralph Lauren on it. It's very simple and sophisticated, and I just really, really love this. I wear this with my Calvins as well and a t-shirt, which I bet like you could literally guess already, but I've worn this to death as well, and it's just so sturdy and beautiful, and I love it, and I think I got it for around $4, so it was a really good find. And my last belt is probably the best one that I've found to date because it's just so cool. I didn't even know this brand made belts, but it is a vintage Tiffany & Co. cherry red medallion belt, and I love it. It just has the Tiffany & Co. on the little medallion. I thrifted this a few months ago, actually, so I haven't really had a chance to wear it because I feel like this red is more of a fall and winter red versus a summer red. So I'm really excited to break this out with a bunch of different things, but it's just so beautiful. It's from the 90s, I believe. I don't really know, but it's suede with the gold buckle, and it's just so beautiful, and I'm in love with it. Alright guys, well that concludes this video. Thank you guys so much for watching. Comment down below what your favorite belt was, and if you like belts, if you collect them. This just goes to show that you can find really cool belts at the thrift store. I love wearing belts because they just add emphasis to an outfit, and they just make me feel more creative, and I love finding them at thrift stores. I'm a huge collector of shoes, bags, and belts. That's just my thing. My dad collects CDs and records. I collect shoes, bags, and belts. I hope you guys enjoyed watching this video. If you liked this video, like this video. Make sure to subscribe, turn the notification bell on so you can get notifications when I post every Monday and Wednesday. If you guys have a video request, just leave it in the comments down below and I'd be happy to film it for you. Or just any styling question, I'd be happy to answer it. If you want to book House of Style for all your styling needs, I'll have that down in the description box below, as well as our website, Facebook page, and Instagram, and make sure to give us a follow on there as well. And thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye.